Good evening, friends. Warm welcome, one and all, for the Super 25 program, India's largest online stock traders conference. Friends, can anyone guess today's session number? We are in the fourth week of the program. Today is session number 20. So which officially means we have completed almost 80% of the program by end of the day. So we have an interesting speaker today, Mr. Anant Rao, who is a co-founder of Kurtosis Analytics and Advisor. Sir, is it Kurtosis or Kurtosis, sir?
It's Kurtosis.
So sorry, sir. Thank you very much. Okay, he has been a very, very senior person, probably the second senior most person in our speaker club of Super 25. He has been a successful analyst, trader, broker, strategist, and investment advisor as well. So he has tremendous amount of experience in equities, currencies, bonds, commodities, and various other topics. And he has been a market commentator in most of the media channels. And he is a regular speaker in most of our industry conferences as well as business schools. Anant sir, it's a great pleasure and honor to have you as a speaker in our program on behalf of the entire Super 25 participants and my extended Traders Gurukul community. I extend my warm welcome to this program.
Thank you, Ashok. Thanks for your generous dose of quotes which you gave about me. I hope people are happy at the end of the day with this topic which I'll be covering today.
Sir, it's all well deserved, sir. So the friends, the topic of today's session is cash. So definitely beyond the strategies which we have learned in various events in the last 20 days or against the theories that we learned, this is going to be an extremely unique session because, as Anant sir says, this is a forgotten asset class. So let's hear from him. Sir, the stage is yours. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Ashok. Thank you. Good evening, everybody. Ashok has already introduced a bit about me. I'll take this opportunity, but before we start, as any good registered investment advisor should say, that the stocks or indices charts which you are going to discuss should not be construed as a buy sell recommendation by our company. We as a firm are only using technical analysis and charts to analyze trends, and certainly we don't consider ourselves as experts in fundamentals. We can be followed on Twitter handle @Kurtosis_IN, which is our company handle, or @KAnantrao, which is my personal handle. Our phone number and email are also mentioned in the footer. So I would start off topic. Now, this is a heart-to-heart discussion between you and me. It's nothing theory about it. Theory is just something which will gradually get into you. So let's only take the flow of learning. Now you see a picture on your screen, picture of a test match with a wicketkeeper and five fielders in one line, and that is called the slip cordon. India is a cricket fanatic nation, so I'll be surprised if you don't follow the game. And there is an old adage in cricket which says, catches win matches. These five people who are lined up, they are called slips. You can see on your picture, since the faces are pretty clear, the first slip is very close to the wicketkeeper who is standing, and that is Shane Warne. The second slip is Mark Waugh, third slip is Ricky Ponting, fourth slip is Justin Langer, and fifth slip is Steve Waugh. These five people are waiting for the batsman to make a mistake, waiting for that edge of his cricket bat which will fly to any of these five people who will have to pounce on that opportunity or a half chance, as they call it. Now, if it is an Australian or a South African pitch, or even sometimes an English wicket, pitches, countries like Australia, New Zealand, England, or South Africa, the pitches are more conducive for fast bowling. So these five gentlemen standing in one line have an opportunity to make the most out of the chances and half chances which comes flying across to them. But do they get a chance to take all the catches which comes off a batsman's bat in that day? No, they also miss. These are specialist fielders who are known. Mark Waugh will never stand at the first slip and Shane Warne will never stand at the fourth slip. It is always in this order. The slip number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are all practiced to be where they are standing. They are specialists. When you have specialists standing in that situation, the odds of they catching an edge is very high. But still, they are humans, so they do mistakes. They drop a catch which they should have taken. It may be a bad day, it may be an oversight, or it may be purely bad luck. Why I am showing you this picture is simply, just like the slip fielders are standing here to pouch that one edge which we call a catch, market also gives us opportunities once in 5 to 8 years to go on cash. In cricket, the best commentators and the experts of the game will tell you most of the time it is the batsman's mistake which costs him his wicket if he gets caught in the slips, rather than the excellent delivery of a bowler. These guys are waiting for the batsman to do that one mistake. In the case of markets, we are the batsman. When we play a rash shot, when we bet on a risky thing, that's when we get caught and trapped and we get out. Classic example would be people who did not exit a Yes Bank at 240, 250. Yes, it made a high at 400, but 40%, 50% below, we should have taken that bullet of exiting it. One example, it is easy to say, I understand, because we are looking from a retrospective perspective, so it's very easy to say. But the real traders and investors, they are the ones who know when to exit and go on cash. Believe me, your investment return can improve significantly if you can take these catches once in 5-8 years. How? Why? When? What is going to be our answer as we start our presentation? One of the biggest investment managers in the industry globally, Ray Dalio, how ironically on 21st of January 2020 in Davos said cash is trash. Now Ray Dalio manages his one fund, Bridgewater Associates flagship fund, manages $160 billion. On 12th of April, his one fund of Bridgewater Associates, the flagship fund, was down 20%. Unheard underperformance by Ray Dalio. Why Ray said that, only Ray knows. But what is ironic here is, the day he said it, Nifty made an all-time high just one day before that. Coincidental, maybe? We all know why we need cash in our portfolio. It's the most simplest thing. We need it so that we can invest in opportunities that may come across in future. Not today, not tomorrow, not 1 week, not 1 fortnight, or not 1 quarter. It could be any time from 1 day to even 2 years. In order to capture those opportunities when they come around, we need cash in our books. And that is why when you look across the fact sheets of mutual funds, you will see they will be having anywhere between 3 to 5% of cash in their portfolio at all given point of time. Many people say that it serves their purpose of meeting redemptions. Agreed, that is one purpose. Another purpose is to meet this opportunity. It's just not the redemption purpose for which mutual funds hold cash in their portfolio. They hold it because also there might be some opportunity wherein they can invest 2% of their entire fund size. Now imagine, I'm talking about 5% of their portfolio. Let's take a classic example. SBI Blue Chip Fund, one of the largest large cap equity mutual funds in this country, with a 20,000 crore approximately cash with corpus. 20,000 crores, 5%. means 1000 crores. That's not a small amount. Similarly, we as retail investors should also have some portion. It could be 20%, it could be 10%. Assuming our average, assuming the average portfolio ticket size of an Indian retail investor is under 5 lakhs, even then we should have at least 10%, that is 50,000 in our portfolio in cash. Because we can then invest in opportunities which may come across in future. Because opportunities will never wait. See, let's take an example, very theoretical example. 2 months ago, when markets crashed and ITC made a bottom at 130, 140. That was an opportunity. In hindsight, at least, even a hindsight, today the stock trades at 180. So it's almost a 40% gain which you have theoretically made. At 130, if you have had the cash, then you would have had the courage to just invest. You cannot borrow courage. You can borrow cash. But if you already have cash, generating courage may not be that difficult. That is why we need cash. Also, some people may use the same cash to do dollar cost averaging into investments as and when prices come down to the buying zone. Say maybe someone had sold ITC at 250, 260. He may have exited with longs. If he had kept that cash lying idle for 3 months, he could have bought it back at 130, 140, 150. So that cash portion of your portfolio gives you that option to invest when an opportunity arrives. That is the only reason we need cash in our portfolio. Any portfolio which is 100% invested is a risky portfolio. The second question here in the same why is why we needed to raise cash. The first question was why we need cash. The second question is why we need to raise cash. Now, what do I mean by raise cash? Raise cash means I'm liquidating a certain portion of my portfolio and I'm converting it from stocks and instruments to cash. We only need to raise cash with one reason: to protect our portfolio. From what? A possible value erosion during a downtrend caused by any number of unforeseen reasons. Now, let's be honest. In 2008, when we had the global financial crisis, we understood it's a global financial crisis only at the fag end of the crisis. Only when Lehman Brothers collapsed in September 2008, we understood the magnitude of the global financial crisis. We were giving it a blind eye when Bear Stearns went up, belly up. We gave a blind eye when AIG went belly up. We gave it a blind eye when, Freddie and Fannie went up. Then we gave it a blind eye when Northwestern Bank went belly up. It was only in the month of September when Lehman went belly up, we were like, oh, it's a global financial crisis now. That awakening moment hit us. So, till that time, that cause was unforeseen. Only after that entire thing happened, we named it, yes, this crash was global financial crisis, GFC. Today, we are enduring a pandemic. Markets peaked on January 20th, 2020. Nifty level was 12,430. Did we name it as a corona crash? No, we did not. Even go back to 2000-2001. Now we call it the dot-com burst. We ended up calling a dot-com burst only after the burst was complete. So the christening part happens later, retrospectively. So we need to raise cash in anticipation. So when we raise it in anticipation, we raise it because we are not comfortable with the markets. And we want to protect our portfolio from possible value erosion. My 100 rupees should not become 30 rupees or 60 rupees again. So in order to protect myself, I am liquidating 60 rupees, 50 rupees, 30 rupees, depending upon my